Hyundai recently redesigned the Sonata sedan. The Sonata hybrid and plug-in hybrid stayed in the previous generation. We're now told the plug-in hybrid is done, but its sibling will continue, and it's back for another round. Witness the fully redesigned Sonata hybrid, which Hyundai estimates could get up to 52 miles per gallon combined. So let's break that down. The Sonata hybrid combines a 2-liter 4-cylinder with an electric motor for a combined 192 horsepower, and power reaches the ground through a 6-speed automatic transmission. All of that is similar sounding to the outgoing Sonata hybrid, but Hyundai says the automatic has fewer shifts and, when they do occur, faster shift times. But overall estimated mileage is 47 miles per gallon in most trim levels, or 52 miles per gallon for a new base trim with less equipment and smaller wheels called the Sonata Blue. Now, Hyundai says those are EPA estimates, but as of now, the EPA has yet to publish anything. Still, if those numbers pan out as such, that's far better than the non-hybrid Sonata. They're also 5 to 11 miles per gallon better than the outgoing Sonata hybrid, as you'd expect if Hyundai wants to compete with hybrid variants of the Honda Accord and Toyota Camry. Now, styling follows the redesigned Sonata with a new grille that has active aerodynamic flaps, a spoiler out back, and new, more aerodynamic wheels. The new Sonata hybrid also has a solar roof system that can recharge both the 12-volt battery and the hybrid battery. Now, this isn't the first time a car has offered solar roof panels. Toyota added available solar roof panels to the prior generation Prius, but those only powered the ventilation system to keep the car cooled when it was parked. Hyundai makes bolder claims here with the Sonata hybrid's solar roof, a feature available on the top trim level. Hyundai says 6 hours of solar charging, give or take, can increase driving range by about 2 miles, regardless of whether your daily range is 8 miles or 800 miles. Officials have told us that range isn't calculated into the Sonata hybrid's EPA ratings, so that car might overperform in real-world fuel economy. Hyundai says it's also optimized battery placement to free up another 2.5 cubic feet of trunk volume compared to the 2019 Sonata hybrid, which was about 3 cubic feet short of the non-hybrid Sonata for 2019 or the redesigned 2020 by Hyundai's published specs. Suffice it to say, Hyundai's claim suggests this trunk is about the same size in the hybrid as it is in the non-hybrid. So how much will the new Sonata hybrid cost? Well, we don't know yet right now, but the new non-hybrid Sonata didn't see a huge price bump with its redesign, so it's a pretty safe bet that the new Sonata hybrid shouldn't see a huge jump over the outgoing Sonata hybrid, which started with destination around $27,000, ended up with factory options up in the mid-30s. All of that should be a lot more apparent closer to the new Sonata hybrid's on-sale date in spring of 2020.